my name is Dikumo, and in today's video I will be washing my hair finally. So I'll be using these four products. From Auntie Jackie's, and they're all from the coconut cream collection recipes, whatever. I've never used these four products together, and I believe they're specifically targeted to type 4 hair, which is my hair type, so I'm excited to see what I'm going to do. And I normally use Auntie Jackie's on my wash days, but I've never used these four together. I normally just use them, let me show it properly. I normally just use the deep conditioner, and I know this works really well on my hair, so I'm excited to see what it does with the other products all together. And I'll be showing them as I use them while I wash my hair. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Before I spend any time, let's just get into it. We've been postponing this wash day for too long now. Let's go. So my hair has been like this. So I haven't washed my hair in over 2 weeks. Don't judge me. I've just been lazy to do this. But today is the day. If you watched my previous video, this is the results of the bunty knots after 3 days, I think. So I'm ready to wash my hair, and it's still moisturized, it's still soft, but it just needs a wash. So I'm excited for that. Let me turn around so you can see. Let's get into it, guys.
You don't know what you do to me. Between me and you, I feel like chemistry. I won't let no one.
So before I put any product in my hair, I make sure to drench my hair in water just to make my hair softer, bring back the moisture, and make it easier for me to section my hair before shampooing. I then apply a generous amount of shampoo on my hands and then to my hair. And let it be noted that when I did this the first time, I wasn't sure whether the cleanser has enough foam to properly wash my hair, but I realized that I didn't put enough product. So once I put enough product, I could see the foam coming through, and I love that in my cleansers, in my shampoos, because I feel like that is the best for me and that cleanses my hair much more. As you can see, I wash my hair in sections, specifically 4 sections, because I believe this is the best method for me so that I can focus on each section and make sure that my scalp and my strands are properly cleansed. I start by shampooing from the roots of my hair and then work the rest of the product on the strands of my hair.
Come and take your place, cause the love you give, you can't be replaced. So go now, and do what you do. That's why I'm spending my life with you.
After shampooing all the 4 sections, I will then go back and rinse out the shampoo section by section. I make sure to keep my hair in these sections because I find it's the easiest way for me to be able to cleanse my hair really well without missing any spots.
Hey. I cleansed my hair twice because I felt that one time wasn't enough and that my hair wasn't properly clean.
So I've put the deep conditioner in my hair and then twisted it. I'm going to leave it for about 10 to 15 minutes.
After the 15 minutes is done, I go back and rinse out the deep conditioner as much as I can, and I keep my hair in these twists because I want my hair to stay stretched.
Personality, everything you do, it's me, love, everything about you. Your smile, your style, so fly, you can't deny, I got a crush on you, and that's true.
If any twists become undone while I'm rinsing out the conditioner, I will go back and twist the hair up again because I do not want my hair to get tangled.
I don't think I can explain how soft my hair feels with that deep conditioner. Like, it's so soft. Oh gosh. It's really soft. And it smells so good. So I'm keeping my hair in twists because I don't want my hair to shrink, and two, I want to work easy in these sections that I've created. If it's in sections and in twists, it makes it so much easier for me to style my hair. Because you can't really see the back and I don't want to look at the back, I'll come back once I have the back of my hair done and then I'll do the front on camera. So I'm back, I did the back of my hair in the shower again. I decided on doing twists. So I start by taking this down. If it comes down. Okay. So I parted my hair the way I wanted to fall once I take the twists out, so that it's easier that way. Then I'm going to take, not like small but not too big parts, sections. I think that's big enough. And then put that away. Take this and then just to detangle, I'm using this detangling brush. This is the best one because it's like this, so it doesn't break your hair, it basically moves with your hair, meaning less breakage. And as usual, I start detangling from the bottom, working my way up. I'm going to use to style. I'm digging you, you make me believe. And then I'm making sure also to concentrate on the ends of my hair. And then once again, detangle. Then twist. When I get to the bottom, I twirl the ends around my finger. And if it needs be, take more gel and twirl. Boom. I'm also taking this as an opportunity to, you know, trim my ends. It's been a minute. So I
just to run it one more time, I apply the sealant to my hair using the praying hands method, then detangle further to thoroughly distribute the product throughout my hair. I then go with the curling gel, also using the praying hands method, and then detangle one more time before I twist down. And when I'm at the end of my twist, I will then twirl the ends around my finger to create that little curl. Because I also wanted to trim my ends, after twirling around my finger, I then cut a little at the ends of my hair. This is not a necessary step, but this is what I needed to do to get my hair back in shape.
So I'm done putting all the twists in my hair, and I'll take them out whenever, maybe tomorrow, maybe the day after. But and my hair feels nice. Those products work really well together, and I'll see how the twists come out to have my final thoughts.
This is all that I trimmed, nothing too hectic, just, you know, taking out all those bad ends. I took the twists out a week later. That's only because I had nowhere to go and I didn't see the need of me taking the twists out. I don't know if that contributed to how the twist out came out, but I really loved the results. While taking down the twists, I try to separate the twists where they want to separate naturally so that I don't cause unnecessary frizz and disrupt the curl pattern. After all the twists are out, I then shake my hair, but then I found that I forgot one twist. There's always that one that you forget to take out. I shake my hair before I use any tools to shape my afro because I believe this helps with how the shape is going to come out. I only pick the roots. I do not go all the way through because I do not want to disrupt the curl pattern.
Hi Shem. No ways. No ways. Seriously? Guys, do you see this? It's giving body, it's giving definition, it's giving volume. I'm obsessed. I'm obsessed. I never get a medium twist out right ever, but this time it's safe to say I'm killing it. No ways. Hello. I'm obsessed. I have no words. Yeah. Let me show the bag before I forget. Ain't she cute? Auntie Jackie's did that. Wow. Just wow. You know, I like my volume. I like my volume. I never get such big hair on day one, hair after I twist out. But this, I've never gotten this, so I'm obsessed. Okay, let me lay my hair, just I'll be right back. Guys, I'm done. I'm obsessed. I attempted to lay my edges only like these parts, but as long as my hairline looks presentable, this is the final look. I'm obsessed. I will definitely be using these products again the same way, because wow, I'm obsessed with everything about this. Like, I'm obsessed.
Thank you for making it this far in the video. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you in the next one.